Ever since I made the Stinger transition tutorial, I've gotten a lot of questions about audio in Blender and how to add your own sound effects to the Stingers. So this week, I'm going to show you how to add audio in Blender, along with all of the ins and outs to make your life just a little bit easier, and all of the proper codec settings for exporting a WebM file with audio. I'm also throwing in some free whoosh, pop, and click sound effects that I recorded myself and you can use for whatever you want. You can get those on the Discord, link in the description. That being said, let's get started. My name is Chris Folea. I'm your stream professor. Welcome to Stream School. So let's say that you just finished either the Stinger transition tutorial or finished going through the Stinger template, and now you have this fancy Stinger that you want to add sound effects to. Or if you're just stopping by trying to figure out how to add audio to Blender, all of the same principles and things that I go through will still apply to you as well. But for those of you not in the know, Blender has an extremely customizable interface. And by that, I mean any one of these panels that you create by just dragging to split or dragging to combine, any one of these panels in the window can be whatever panel you want it to be. So just because my screen is laid out like this doesn't mean you can't follow along if yours is different. So for instance, if I want to change this panel, I can change it to anything I want. Same with literally any other panel on the window. That being covered, the panel we want to work with today is the video sequencer. So if we come up to one of these buttons on whichever panel you want to use, I'm gonna use this one myself. You can come over here, click video sequencer, and it will look just like this. You have the playhead, and you can scroll through to figure out where you wanna add your sound effect. And then adding your sound effect is as easy as coming up to this menu right here, clicking add and sound. Then you just want to navigate to wherever your sound file is and you want to bring it in. So I'm going to do switchinscenes.wav. And now if I go to the beginning and play switchinscenes, you see that we get our audio in Blender. And then you can just click and drag that to wherever you want. Now, to make your life a little bit easier to see the waveform and see where the audio actually starts or if there's any delay in it starting, you can click display waveform. And if this isn't showing, you can hit N on your keyboard to show or hide it. Or just click this little arrow right here if it's hidden. So if you click display waveform, now you can see where the audio actually starts, and we can drag this around. Switching scenes. And you might want the audio to play while you're scrubbing through the timeline as well. So my preferred thing to do is go down here to the timeline and hit playback and then choose audio scrubbing. And that makes it so when you scrub through, switching scenes, it'll sort of play the audio so you can tell what's happening along with your animation. Obviously, it's a little bugged out because we're not dragging our playhead at the exact frame rate that it needs to play, but it gives you a good idea of what's happening with the audio as you scrub through. Then you can also go to playback, and where it says no sync, you want to change that to AV sync. So whenever you play back, switching scenes, the software will keep your audio synced up with the animation or the video. Switching scenes. Switching scenes. And you have a few more options here. For one, you can change the volume of this, so you can scroll that all the way up, but you'll notice that's turning red where it's starting to clip. You don't want that. You can also turn it down if you want it to be like really quiet, like a whisper. Switching scene. Or even loud. Switch. Insane. Sorry for you headphones users out there. I'm gonna leave mine at 1 because it's already pretty good. You can also change the pitch. So if we want this to be higher pitched, we can just drag this over a little bit. It's very sensitive, so don't change the values too much, but you can go
switch and scenes.
And that's pretty funny.
Switch and scenes.
Or you can make it low pitched as well. But if we turn this one down,
switch and scenes,
you'll notice it gets cut off at the end here. And it won't actually let you drag that out any further. But you can fix that by going to time and then changing the duration here. So if we change this to however long we need it to be,
switching scenes,
now it'll actually play through properly. I'm gonna leave mine at a pitch of 1, just like that. Quick side note here, you can also animate these parameters individually as well. And first of all, you're gonna wanna make sure no 3D objects are selected, because that sort of adds extraneous keyframes to the timeline if they're animated. So you can deselect everything by hovering over the 3D viewport and hitting Alt-A on your keyboard, and that clears off the keyframes from the timeline as well. So then, let's say you wanna use the volume slider to fade in. You can come to the start of the sound effect, you can select volume, set that to 0, hit enter, then hover over it, hit I on your keyboard to insert a keyframe, scroll to where you want to fade into, change it to 1, hit enter. Notice how it turns orange. That means the value has been changed, but it hasn't had a keyframe set yet. So then you can just hover over it, hit I on your keyboard to insert a keyframe, and now you'll notice that it fades
in.
And you can do the same thing with the pitch. So if we wanted this to start out at like a low pitch, hit I to insert a keyframe, scroll forward, then pitch it up to maybe 1.2, hit I to insert another keyframe.
Switching scenes.
It sounds
switching scene.
Kind of stupid and funny, but I just wanted you to know that that was an option. Then there is one easier way to do fade-ins for this sound effect. So if I undo all of this, and set that back to 1. You can also just right click on this sound effect or any sound effect, go to fade, then you have a bunch of different options for fade in and out, fade in, fade out, from playhead to playhead, and these just automate what we just did. So if we do fade in, for instance, it just automatically creates the keyframes for us, and we can select those keyframes and drag them along however we want. I personally prefer to do this manually just for ultimate control, but just know that that is also an option. Side note over. You'll also notice how this has multiple tracks. So if I grab the entire thing and drag it, you can drag it up and down in the tracks. That allows you to have multiple audio tracks as well. So let's say I want to add a whoosh sound effect. I can go to add sound. I can get one of my convenient whoosh sound effects that I recorded. I can display the waveform, and let's say I just want to use only one of these. This is a collection of whooshes.
Switching scenes.
So I only want to use one of them, so I'm going to grab just the end and drag it to where that one starts, and then I'm going to drag the end of it a little bit closer to where we need this to be. And you notice that I can change how much of the timeline is visible right here. You can also scroll in and out with the mouse wheel, but I'm just gonna cut this off where I need it to be. And let's say I want this to whoosh like right as it comes in. So drag this over here.
Switching scenes. Switching.
Maybe even start it a little bit earlier.
Switching scenes.
It's not the best whoosh sound effect in the world, but it's fine for what we're doing right now. Then you can hit Shift D to duplicate that as well. And I can drag this over. So now when we wipe out, maybe have it start right there.
Switching scenes. Switching scenes.
And now you have some sound effects. So the next step is going to be to export this thing. And you do need to change some of the codec settings from the settings that I set up previously. So you go to the little printer icon right here. And then you can come down here where it says codec. And you notice I have FFmpeg and WebM. So now you need an audio codec that's compatible with WebM. So for that, you can go to audio codec and Vorbis will work just fine. And that's all you have to click. That's all you have to apply. Then it's the same export process as previously. So if I go down to wherever I want to export this, I'm going to do this as Stinger with audio and hit enter. Then go to render and render animation. And that should leave us, when it's all said and done, with a WebM file that has my sound effects in it. So now if I come into OBS and we add ourselves a new stinger and call this one Audio Stinger, hit OK, browse for my specific file, which is going to be under Stream School and How to Audio. Grab it and then set the transition point. For me, I'm going to set it to 1 second. Preview that. And then for audio, can change that to monitor only if I have a two PC setup. Switch and scenes. And you'll notice that it works fine. So if we have this audio stinger and we switch now to a different scene, switch and scenes, we have audio on our stinger, exactly what we wanted. And that's pretty much all there is to it. If you found this video helpful, make sure you hit that like and subscribe button below the video for new content every single week. And if you have any questions or just want to come hang out with our incredible community, I'm live every Tuesday, Friday, and Saturday at twitch.tv/oraclefishlive. Until next time, my name is Chris Folea. I'm your stream professor. Class is out.